Over Washington is made possible by a grant from Bank of America, offering an array of financial services dedicated to making banking work for you.
Washington has been a place of fierce and fond discovery for the past 200 years, luring the adventurous first by sea, and then over landscapes peerless in their grandeur. And yet, in all that time, few have had the chance to explore and capture Washington's beauty from the most ethereal approach of all, from above. The sea stacks are the old remnants of the continent. They're the living witness of the incredible power and relentlessness of the sea, quarrying away at the land itself. Thank you. walk among these mountains, I realize how little has changed since the last ice age. I thank God that our forefathers had the wisdom to preserve this vast wilderness, and hope that we will be as vigilant in our responsibility to maintain its natural beauty. I leave the roaring engine rooms to look at the passing scenery. They've got a name for everything. I look at the inlets and jetties, knowing that I could be in a small boat exploring, passing through. There's so many things to find. Passing through, I could anchor for the night.
Thank you.
The serenity of the climate, the innumerable pleasing landscapes, and the abundant fertility that unassisted nature puts forth require only to be enriched by the industry of man with villages, mansions, cottages, and other buildings to render it the most lovely country that could be imagined. We felt like we were the gatekeepers to Puget Sound. We helped guide all sizes of ships in their comings and goings. The park scenery increased in beauty, and it was almost impossible to realize that we were in savage and wild country, and that nature, not art, had perfected the landscape. I am the envy of my 49 colleagues, for my domain is one of the grandest in all the country. Not a day goes by that the beauty of Puget Sound does not somehow touch my life. In the hope that Seattle will remain one of the best-kept secrets in the country, I'll shout that the rains are torrential, the mud knee-deep, and the slugs carnivorous. It's only in a whisper that I'll say how much I love it.
Thank you.
forest trees press forward to the water around all the windings of the shores in a most imposing array, as if they were courting their fate, coming down from the mountains far and near to offer themselves to the axe.
On their way from the Cascades to the Sound, the rivers have, over time, given us a gift of fertile soil, upon which are rooted now the many pastoral farms of the Skagit and Stillaguamish basins. Look out upon these jagged spires that march north to Canada, south toward Rainier. A grand procession of peaks, forming the spine that separates west from east, wet from dry, green from gold.
Tinge of gold, lending an austere beauty to that endless, rolling, smooth world. 1,000 hills laid bare to the sky, a lonely, hard, heroic country. Water does not linger in this region by nature's design. Instead, we have to capture, store, and direct the water to make the desert bloom.
The bluffs resemble statuary, castles, forts, and temples, as if nature, tired of waiting for the advance of civilization, had erected her own temples. There was a time in the past when the Spokesman Review Building was the tallest structure in Spokane. I never would have dreamed that today there would be so many beautiful buildings standing so tall over the Inland Empire.
Thank you.
Columbia, once a great green serpent of writhing, frothing waters, has been tamed by a succession of dams, its energy converted into electricity, its churning rapids transformed into a placid marine highway.